Hello everybody, this is Theron. Welcome to the Minecraft 1.9 Snapshot Tour. Today is August 29th, 2015, and yesterday on Friday, today Saturday, Mojang released not one, but three snapshots, which A, it's unusual for them to release on Friday, and especially since they had released on Monday was their sort of intended snapshot day. So they released snapshot 15W35 C, D, and E all on the same day before I had a chance to download any of them, because I think there were some pretty major bugs in the previous one. So I played a little bit of 15W35 B. So I don't know if they were trying to correct something in there. We will find out. I do have world backups, but let's get started. Snapshot tour. So, I did a little bit off camera. As you will see, woohoo, we're in a swamp. And there's squids in the swamp, which is weird. Anyway, home's over that way, not too far. I wandered up around this way and found on the other side of this little berm, chickens and sheep. So I herded a bunch of chickens into a hole. Woohoo, to get eggs, because I'm not going to try and lead chickens back over to home. Because it's kind of silly, but I need feathers and stuff. So I've got a bunch of eggs, and I can make chickens. And the sheep I've been shearing, we'll try and lead some over. I do have some wool here, a little bit. And because we're in a swamp, there was a slime, and so I got some slime balls, which is nice. Don't have a real good slime situation back at home yet. Don't need too much slime. Yeah. Oh, come here. Give me your wool. Give me your wool. And frankly, I don't know that I really need the sheep. I'll need some wool. Not a lot. Just enough to make some beds and carpet and stuff. Not too much. So I don't know that I need to actually put together a little sheep farm back at the house or the hole in the ground. So I got a bunch of naked sheep running around here. Some stuck like this, and as I'm finding chickens that have survived the whole apocalypse, I'm killing them for their chicken meat and feathers. So just wandering around trying to kill the rest of the swamp chicken. Haven't wandered too far past this, and there might be some fun stuff up here. There's some neat terrain. There's some mountains here. Those are tall birch trees, aren't they? So I may go get some birch saplings. That actually might be a really good idea. Let's do that over here. Clay. I don't know that I need my... Oh. Is that what I think it is? Time's... It's still morning. I think that is... Get closer. Yes, that's a witch hut. Oh, this one's in a good position, too. Look at this. Surrounded by water. Nice. I don't know that we'll be doing anything with this, but there's a cauldron in there if I want it, I guess. Oops. Ah, don't drown. Oh, wow. So one thing I noticed on the Minecraft LAN party server, the witch farm seems to have stopped working as of Minecraft 1.8.8. It doesn't, the shifting floor design doesn't actually make anything drop through the floor much. So I don't know what the problem is. So I need to go troubleshoot it and figure it out, but so we're running into all of the redstone and glowstone and stuff that and gunpowder that we collected from there. I have quite a bit of it, but it's not accumulating anymore, which could be a problem. So I need to do a little research to see what's going on there. But okay, guys, drop some saplings. don't need the wood so much. One thing we need to do back at the house is work out a storage solution, because right now, hi sapling, because right now storage is kind of limited. I've got two double chests and that's it. So I can make a bunch of chests with all the wood I've got here, and I have that big spruce tree outside that should give me all the wood I need. And I need to do some more resource gathering, but I'm not going to bore you with that on camera, I don't think. One thing, I am feeling a little bit better equipped since I have the iron armor and still in pretty good shape. And I've got, I need to make more arrows, but I've got some feathers now. It's down here. Nothing. Okay. Oh, look, there's some iron down there. Iron's still a relatively valuable commodity. Oh, hello. Well, this is cute. Does that go past? Is this asking for trouble? Probably. Keep an eye on your back. Oh yeah, we could get lost in here. Easily. More iron. More iron. Hello, Mr. Zombie. Oh, I wish one of these zombies would drop a potato or something. I still don't have haven't found a village. Oh, Mr. Whoa, oh, goodness. Can you pathfind up to me here, or are you going to die in the lava? Okay, this could be a bad situation. So let's get this iron and get out of here, because we don't really need to be in this cave. Coal's still useful, too. I hear a spider, don't I? Oh, hello. Spider off in the distance. Okay. And a load of gravel here could be useful. Oops. Don't do that, Theron. Oh, this. Come on, get your act together. Oh, dead end, okay. Hello, Mr. Iron. I hear more beasties behind me. There's probably a cave system back there. Okay. I don't know that I care too much. This goes up. I see light up there. Oh, I saw light. That was weird. Okay, it's a dead end though. Let's get this iron. Iron. Okay, let's go back down. Get past this little. Man, I miss with. Ah, come on. You can do it. There we go. And there was iron up in the wall here. Oh, it's almost nighttime too. Okay, let's get back up. Any more saplings? Here we go. All right, so I've got 6 birch saplings. I got 47 wood. I've got more. That witch hut. Another birch sapling. Okay, let's get back over to a little lean-to. The sun's going down. Let's sleep. And then in the morning, we'll wake up, grab some eggs and slime and wool, and head back to the hidey hole. And we'll try to figure out a storage situation so that we can store more stuff. Don't need a huge amount of stuff, but we need more storage space than we have currently. And now that we have cows, we have leather, and woo. And that means we can start making books. Because we should have plenty of... woohoo! Give me your eggs. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, sure. Let's smelt this while we're here. And put this here. This here. A lot of this stuff. So we'll take this back with us. And we may need that for dye. Sputter is... got leather, which is useful. Lily pads might be. Couple of these, couple of these, couple of these. And pop, 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 pop. Oh yeah, we'll need to cook some of that too. Oh, I don't have any place to put it. And it's getting dark. Let's go to sleep. Wake up. Hey guys. Oh, I really don't need to be carrying that, or that, or that, or that. Stick's not terribly useful. Iron! Woohoo. No, so I've got 25 levels. We're gonna be at level 30 soon. I wanna have a complete setup, enchanting setup at some point. I just heard another egg being laid. Okay. There we go. And I got this raw chicken here, but honestly, it's just one. I will soon be swimming in chicken. So let's grab these. Wait for this to cook up. Finish cooking. And we can take it back with us. Boop. I dug down here to get some cobblestone to make the furnace, but I haven't really done any other digging around here since. Hey guys. Another 22 iron, which is enough for another set of stuff, of armor. Do I have... how many feathers here? Oh, I don't have any... I don't have any... flint! I've got some back at the hole. Which you'll see is not that far that way. I didn't wander very far. This was the... I came up this way because the only direction from the hole that I really hadn't explored too much. Hi, squids. I had gone the other cardinal directions, just not this way. Oh, it's so slow. Okay. I'm going to wait for the rest of this, and then we'll come back and get ready for the journey back home. All right. Say goodbye. We are heading home. So, sorry about the air conditioning noise. I'm sure you can hear it. It got really hot today. Well, it got hot today. In Los Angeles here, in the area where I live, it was like 99 degrees at its peak, I think. It was pretty bad. And we had a weird electrical issue yesterday. My wife texted me and told me that the air conditioner was acting up. It wasn't outputting cold air. Yesterday was hotter than it was today, and So that was bad. And the air conditioning is kind of critical because we have dogs. So we need to prevent them from getting their little brains cooked. So, and it turned out that not only was the air conditioner acting up, but about half of the outlets in the house, about half the circuits in the house, were not outputting anything. Oh, come back here. I know, that hurts. Ugh, little hearts are heartbreaking. Ugh. But you have leather, and I need your leather. Don't worry, I'll make plenty more cows. Just, you're the one that I have to sacrifice. And your meat's pretty good, too. Okay. So, our air conditioner's pretty old. It was here at the house when we bought it. And let's go the right direction. That would help. We don't want to get lost. And it's held on pretty well for longer than we thought it ever would. So that was... and occasionally the bearing in the heat exchange fan gets squeaky and starts acting up. And I'm pretty sure that's the part that's going to die first. Hey, bunnies. Sorry, I don't have any carrots. Otherwise, I'd lead you home. Not that I need anything from the bunnies. So I was thinking that maybe... And my wife went outside to the actual AC unit. Ooh. Must have a cave down here. I wonder if there's a spawner. Here's a cave. I don't want to spend too much time here. We're pretty close to home. More iron. Oh, but not much else. There's a cave down there, and there are zombies in it. I wonder if there's a spawner there. That could be handy. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What do I want to sacrifice? Oh, good. What do I want to sacrifice? The one arrow I have? No, arrows are too precious. We will sacrifice the orchids. Oh, this is dumb. Iron axe that's mostly chewed up. Yeah, that's got enough iron here to make more. And hopefully we'll have more diamonds soon. And we can make a diamond axe. Oh, I wonder if it's down here. Interesting. Okay, we'll come back and look at that. So my thought was that the air conditioner with the fan that had stopped going, that the bearing in the fan finally gave out, and that it was... Somehow it was going over current and dragging down the power in the rest of the house in a weird way. We went and looked, and none of the breakers had tripped, so it was kind of odd. So we were trying to call the electrician that we used to rewire the house, and we have a lifetime warranty from them. Not super thrilled with the work they did in some cases, but. You know, if it was a wiring thing, then they are responsible for it. And, but they were closed because it was a Friday night. And so we were trying to figure out, but like half of the lights in the house. Like, if you drew a line down the center of the house, front to back, every light on the left of the house, for the most part, was out, was not working. And the stuff on the right side of the house was working. It was just weird. So, are we going the right way here? No. Well, here's the river. Cool. So it was just weird. And I got home and of course, you know, the kitchen was out. Fortunately, there we go. There's home. Fortunately, the refrigerator was still working. So that could have been bad. Yeah, unfortunately, our internet, our router and DSL modem. Hello. You're in a weird place. So we didn't have any internet because all that stuff was in the affected portion of the house, which was kind of weird. But, hey guys. It's starting to get dark. Let me make some chickens here. I have the dual effect of clearing out some inventory space and making chickens. Oops, sorry. There we go. We want some eggs so that we can make cake. So then I went to bed. I ran an extension cord from the side of the house where the power was working to all the internet stuff so that we could actually have internet and look up the phone number of the place that of the place that had done the electrical work for us, and just, you know, check email and whatnot. But I should go back inside and sleep over here, so reset my spawn. So I went to bed, and then about 4 o'clock in the morning, I woke up and just feeling like I needed to check out the lights, check out the power. Power was, of course, all still out, but so was the rest of it. And we had all the windows open, so I was able to hear that there was somebody a couple streets over. It sounded like a big truck, and I thought maybe they were working on the things. I looked at the LADWP website, and they did not list our area as being affected by any power outages, which was kind of weird. So I was starting to wonder if there wasn't a larger problem. Hey guys. Okay. Let's go see what flit we have. Let's make some arrows. Let's make some more chests. Let's work on that. Sorry, I have 3 double chests. So yeah, at 4 o'clock in the morning, there was all kinds of commotion. Oh, I had some birch saplings. Of course I did. Okay, so I'll need these for more books. I have leather. Oh, we can make some more books and get the bench crafting. All the power was out, including the refrigerator at 4. So I was a little concerned, but I figured, well, we'll just wait until the morning. There's not much I can do right now. And I was having trouble getting back to sleep. And about 4:30, I heard all the sort of circuits in the house come back on. So obviously there was a problem. And when I heard that, I got up and I went around and started turning on the lights, including the lights that had not been working. And guess what? They were all working now. So oops, I need that for the books. So I'm starting to think that we were having some sort of a brownout situation, and that the LED DWP was out and they were working on it, and that they fixed the problem at about 4:30 in the morning. We left the AC off, even though it was hot inside the house, because I did not want to, like, stress things out, or I don't know, I didn't want to tempt fate. So we left the AC off, and this morning, after confirming that everything was still on, we turned the air conditioning back on, and it came on and started to work. It's been playing catch-up, though, so it is still pretty hot inside the house. As I said, it's an old AC unit, and it doesn't work super awesome. So we, do I not have another one of you guys? There you go. There we go. More cows, more leather. You guys can grow. Hi, chickens. You can all grow up. Start laying eggs. You can make more chickens. I may make a chicken cooker, because I know where lava is. And I've gotten a few bits of quartz out of the nether, so we can make comparators and repeaters, because I have redstone. So, anyway. So that's that. So fortunately, it wasn't that our air conditioner had died. It is that we had probably an undervoltage situation in the house and didn't realize it. And I wish now that that had occurred to me, I would have gotten my multimeter and checked the voltage levels of the outlets while we could have. But not super important. Important thing, everything's working now. The air conditioner is playing catch up, so I'm not, I would normally turn it off while recording. There we go. Ooh, 9 arrows. Okay. Need more flint. That I may have to do with some deliberation. We have gravel up here. No. Okay. To the mines. So anyway. So AC noise. And it's difficult to remove and with noise reduction, so I'm not gonna do it. Okay, let's start our new shaft over here. I have 54 torches. That'll get us a little ways, and we'll have to make more. And we're on the lookout for gravel. So what else is new? Had a call with lawyer yesterday about our situation with my mom's estate. So that's going to be, I'm going to have to spend some time up in the Bay Area helping out, collecting documents and whatnot. My dad, the house and everything was in my mom's name because my dad was collecting Medi-Cal, and they were told that they needed to get all the assets out of his name. The lawyer told us it probably wasn't necessary because there are certain exemptions, like they won't take a house or a car, because those are kind of important. You need a place to live and a way to get around. So that was, it's going to unfortunately complicate our lives, but it's fine. I think we have the memorial service. It's not really a service. We're going to do a little wake for my mom sometime in after Labor Day, I think. And we're asking the people, in lieu of sending flowers, that they make a donation to the American Lung Association, because it would be really nice if lung cancer weren't effectively a death sentence. Which, oh, hello. I've been over here. How did I get over here? Okay, we're wrapped around there, I guess. Okay. Let's patch this up a little bit, because it doesn't really need to be open access. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oops. Interesting. But no gravel, which is what I really need. Oh, okay. I remember where this is. Hello. All right. We'll take out that. And we will. This probably infuriates some of you, but frankly, I don't need to get into those caves. So let's do that. See if we can dig past them. It's probably. Oh, iron. Hello. And redstone. Nice. So let's see. Today. What did I do today? What did you do today? Today we went. I slept in a little bit once I was able to actually get back to sleep after the power came back on. And we went. We went and got some lunch. We got some pizza. There's a pizza place called Luggage Room Pizza in Pasadena. It's built in what used to be the luggage room of the Del Mar train station, which is now a train station, but it's like light rail train. And they make yummy pizza, and including a very good gluten-free pizza crust. I am not, as I've probably mentioned, I'm not a celiac. I don't have celiac disease. I, however, am allergic to a number of things, including wheat. So that kind of sucks. Why does that look different? But I can go have pizza there, which is nice. And they have Mexican Coke. So we can pizza and a Coke. And my wife can have a regular pizza. And so we can do that. Dirt. Feels like I should have more gravel somewhere. But we will. So we did that. Then we stopped at a restaurant supply store. We have friends coming over tomorrow night. I wanted to make some ribs. And lapis! So I like cooking ribs with, I have a sous vide cooker, the Namiku. And it does a really good job with ribs. But I have a little stock pot that I use for the sous vide, which works well for a lot of stuff, and for a one side of like pork back ribs, you cut it in half, they fit in the stock pot with the sous vide cooker pretty nicely. But that's really only enough for two of us, and we have a couple friends coming over, so I wanted to get another set of ribs in the cooker. And it was a little tight, and so I've been meaning to get a Lexan food storage container to do the sous vide cooking in. And I should have picked one up yesterday. There's a very good restaurant supply store in Culver City called Surface. And I was out over that way yesterday. I went to Crash Space last night to help somebody with some 3D printing, and oh, hey, gravel. So I went. I was out in the neighborhood, and uh, And so I should have gone to surface to and picked one up, because they certainly would have them. Didn't think about it, so we went to this place called Restaurant Depot, which, if you ever watch cooking channel shows, like especially Top Chef, Restaurant Depot is one of the places they sometimes go to get their food stuff, their ingredients. It's a nice little place. It's kind of like a warehouse type store where they have they have bulk items, like a restaurant might go there to pick up their steaks and their produce and all that good stuff. So we went, and it's a membership sort of situation, but we have managed to talk ourselves into a membership. They have like wholesale pricing. So I went in and we bought ourselves a Alexan storage container, and the sous vide cooker fits in it nicely. So now I've got two whole racks of ribs that are cooking away. And I like leaving the ribs in the sous vide for about 36 hours. So it'll be a little short, but for dinner tomorrow night, but that's fine. They'll still be yummy. They'll certainly be cooked. They cook pretty quickly. The duration we're cooking, I like cooking them at 138 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know what that is in Celsius. Doesn't matter. Celsius degrees are too big. So they're not really precise enough for cooking. You have to get into decimals, and it's just no. And although I'm pretty conversant in metric and most other areas, never really got used to the metric, the Celsius scale for temperature. I mean, I have a sense that, you know, I know that zero is freezing point of water, and that 100 is the boiling point of water. And that's all fine and dandy, but so the ribs are cooking somewhere below 100 degrees Celsius. Oh, more iron. But definitely above zero. So I don't know. I could figure it out if I needed to, but I don't really need to. I could set the sous vide cooker to work in Fahrenheit. It works just fine. So, so I know that at 140 degrees, collagen starts doing weird things, and it starts denaturing, and in not a good way. They sort of turns into a sponge and kind of squeezes itself. And it'll squeeze a lot of the water out of the meat. And the collagen is the connective tissues. So normally when you cook in ribs, you heat them up to, you want to get the collagen to melt, and it melts at around 160. But 160 is overdone for the ribs themselves. So the idea with sous vide is I can cook them to the desired doneness, which is about 140 degrees. And then leave them in long enough that it'll take care of any microorganisms or anything that's in them. But it doesn't necessarily get the texture right. So I like doing it just below 140 for about 36 hours. That seems to be a good sweet spot. And the collagen gets loose. It doesn't denature and get all tough. So the meat is nice and tender. Still has a lot of the moisture in it. And they get to be like they're falling off the bone. So that's kind of the way you want your ribs. And then it's just a normal dry rub rib. Hello, Mr. Zombie. And you're around somewhere. See if we can find you. So that's making ribs. And they turn out really nice in the sous vide. And then when I get them done, we get them out of the cooker. When we're ready to eat them, we go toss them on the grill for a minute or two to try and get some grill marks on it and sort of get the some color in it and the Maillard reaction or whatever you want to call it, whatever it's called, that you get a lot of good flavor out of the searing part, but you only want that on the outside. So I do have a blowtorch here somewhere that might be a good way of doing it. I just go throw them on the grill for a minute, and that puts the grill marks on them. Come out nice and tasty, so we'll have to see how they go. I've been recording for a while. This is going to be a long episode. Okay, well, let's I'm going to call it there, and I'm going to keep digging. Need more gravel so I can make more arrows. And in the next episode, I'm thinking we go back into the Nether and see if we can find ourselves a fortress and get ourselves a blaze rod or two, because that is the next step. I need potions, and that would be very handy. And some potions and some gas tears, so we can make regeneration potions, because that would make going to the end and also fighting the wither a little bit more easier. So anyway, we're gonna call that an episode then. I'm just gonna keep on going. Oh, my inventory's almost full anyway. And if I find these zombies, like if I find myself a spawner, that would be great. I'll come back and we'll show you that. But otherwise, I will see you next time, and hopefully we'll be ready to venture into the Nether. All right, thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye.